I don't want to die. I really don't. At first glance, it doesn't seem like the best solution to moms. But the more I think about it, the more I know that there is no other solution. The choices laid before me just aren't fair. I can continue living this pathetic, meaningless life, or I can end it and discover what waits for us after death. I regret the things I never did. I regret the things I never said. I wish I could grow up in this world and look back on my choices and laugh with my friends as we remind ourselves of the good times that I haven't even had yet. But it seems that the friends I have are doomed to remember me as the pathetic man that I was. I know now that there were a thousand better ways to live my life up until now, but I didn't. I picked the most upsetting and pointless life. You will all look at me and realize that I was just a coward. I thought my life was too difficult, so I put an end to it. There are people out there who have a much harder life than I do, and all I can say to them is that they are much stronger than I. To those of you with abusive parents or school bullies, to the people out there with money problems or fear of the future, to the women with cheating husbands and the men with whoring wives, to the children who think that their lives aren't worth living, I say to you, keep moving forward. For my sake and the sake of those who fell to their own hands before me, for the sake of the people who thought life was too scary, keep living. And he put an exclamation point on that. He's telling you, don't do this, don't do this, don't do this. I want to be able to look in on the world from wherever I end up and see you struggling. Not because I want to watch you suffer through your lives, but because I want to watch you make a difference. I want the world to turn into a beautiful place where no one is scared, and I don't need to be here for it to do that. I had so many friends in my life, so many good people, and a few who made bad choices. I loved every single one of you, and no one could ask for better friends. You put up with my crap and cared for me anyway. I was a jerk, and I know you talked about me now and then when I wasn't around, and I don't blame you. I was a bad person. And even if you were just pretending to like me, I don't care. You were still my friends. I will miss you, but I hope you won't miss me. I had way too many friends to talk to each one of them directly, so to that nerdy redheaded best friend of mine, there are so many memories we will never make, and I will miss you so much. One of these days, you're going to make a name for yourself, and everyone will know you. You will be rich, but you will stay and still make time to go to RenFest. And by the way, your Skyrim case and book are laying on my floor. I'll have someone send them to you. Go out into the world and remind them that I had a great best friend. There was a girl in my life, my what-if girl. She knows who she is, and hopefully she's hearing this. You are beautiful. Where are you? You are beautiful.
About you, from your mind to your soul, you radiate beauty and you light up the world like a star. I will be so sad knowing that I will never see you again. I know sometimes you feel the same way that I do, but you shouldn't. People care about you, I care about you, and now I know you have some scars to hide, but you shouldn't. Don't hide them, because your scars make you beautiful. And I'm not just talking about your arms, but the scars on your heart that will never heal. I know that you have lost a lot, and I hope you won't be sad by my passing. And I know it's not my place, but plan to cover everything I wanted to say, but hopefully it will get through. Goodbye.
There's so many things that go through our heads, and we try to find something to blame it all on. We want to get mad at God, we want to get mad at each other. I want to blame them, he wants to blame me. We all want to find a reason to make sense out of all this. The only thing that I can figure out is this was what was supposed to happen. This is what his purpose was. It was so that you could be here today. God doesn't make mistakes. He doesn't make mistakes.
Amen.
He knew before Dalton was born that Dalton was going to die. He even knows when I'm going to die, when you're going to die, when we're all going to die. He knows how we're going to die. He knows everything. So he knew that you would be here today. He knew that you would have loved Dalton for 16 years and that you would be torn apart right this moment and your heart would be raw and open and your ears are listening, your eyes are opening, and God can now speak to you. He can now get through you. It was purposed. And I hate it. I hate that. That Dalton is the martyr for the battle for our souls. But very proud at the same time. I don't know if that makes any sense. Proud that God would use my son in this way to reach 9,000 on and on and on and on and on. And we're not going to stop here. We're just getting started. We're just getting started in figuring out all the ways that we can make this make sense. All the ways that we can help you. I couldn't help Dalton, but I will listen to each and every one of you if you want to come to me and tell me that you're hurting. I would have listened to him. I love my son very much.